Welcome back, and you've made it to our prime time show, where we'll face two heroes of the fantasy world kingdom against each other. And the show, let's get into a deathmatch! And they will assess every power, ability, and qualities to find out who will win. Deathmatch! Now on to the character profiles.
And our first deathmatch contestant, by the legendary John Carmack, owner of ID Software, is the Super Bad, indulging in Omnipunctious Secret Holding and Super Soldiering, Doomring! You'd say Doom is a trendy, ego-attaching, creative super fantasy world, with the Doom community and all the significant science fiction pants of space euthemia, and draw you into its world of adventure. And now a little bit about the Doom Marine. First off, the Doomguy has very many attachable identities. Flynn Peter Taggart, Buddy Dackett, Tara Dina Cassatt, BJ Blazkowicz, John Carmack, Michael Biehn, Arnold Schwarzenegger, John Matrix, Roland Trigg, Warren Apisa, Melanie Butch Fuselli, Janella Sabando, Demon Slayer, Doom Slayer, Doomguy, John Kane, John Grimm, Don Portman, Stan Blazkowicz, Space Marine, Space Commando, the Super Bad Superman, the Doom God, the Anunnaki Knight, Leo the Lion, UAC Marine, and the Alien Ass Kicker! Doom instills superficial psych mood, sensations, and senses of orgasmic euthemia. Come on, Kenneth Solomon, trying to get to bed and give up that dooming for the night. For a psychoanalytical sample test on you. Remember that night, on that never-ending twilight evening tonight on the night highway when you were only 6 years old, alongside a massive plane's one in the mountainside, then continue into a rural-like cruise with night stars gleaming. Remember that daytimer's feeling playing on your RGB computer, that self-immersed ecstatic glowing sensation, like something is godlike, super special. How about Christmas euthemia, alien psychedelia, immersion in egopathy, the progressive adventurous proudness of experiencing the shareware Doom, the crimson suspense and superficial indulgence of Final Doom for the PlayStation, Final Doom starry days and gaze ecstasy. That's Doom! And that's an analysis of these moods do point to uncover that these might have been the very orgasmic psych moods of John Carmack throughout his science fiction, science geekoid, and fantasy gaming and military admiring childhood. Not uncommon for the most interesting rare Leo to beloved these things as mind and their exaggerated egos, in which the Doomguy is also Leo pastiching and depicting the similarities of ID Software fantasy patron and lead company founder John D. Carmack. Now on to the next deathmatch contestant. And our second challenging deathmatch contestant, the king of Walmart sales, next generation casual science fiction and video gaming promotions by Bungie Software, is the formidable Master Chief with his titanium Majolar armor, commonly attracting egopathic geeks and extraordinary superhero fanatics about being overpowerful and formidable with attrition armor narcissism. Master Chief is the bomb, the next possible icon amalgam of the Doom Marine, whereas Master Chief is casual orient, that means the hero freak scammed, violence grunge balls and fad freaks, and updated generations of fantasy and gaming. The Doom Marine is of specialized personal orient, which veers with the non-mainstream real-life superheroes and true elder science fiction geeks with and themic space fantasy patrons. Holy shit, I can tell you this Halo ain't even beat Space Quest. Roger Wilkle even entertains better than Master Chief. Slime alien or pissed off Teletubby, it's your choice, honky tonky. So that's a minus on Master Chiefy. Well, this concludes our analysis. Let's move on to a deathmatch in space.
Master Chief. Little did you know, I can get very, very, very violent and exotic. Survival. So now this Berserker pack is making me really crazy. I'm the Lioness of Fortune. I am Death Incarnate. I can substitute for Godzilla on his best day. Ha 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 ha. I feel like 9.0 on the Richter scale. I don't want this needle. It ruined my life. It made me lose a lottery. It feels good, and you can have this needle instead.
He's right there, you defiancy. Just evade me again and I'll blast you apart, maggot. Holy shit, you're 9.0 on the Richter scale? Damn it, HQ, the bastards use these berserker packs with war dusters on. Help, back up!
I saw them all to dust. I was the Vatican that murdered the remaining Stockholm Serpent Riders, baby. It was me. Bloodshed, 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 blood, and then to the shed. As evil as the devil, training with Lieutenant Hawkeye Crawford. The Beepers, always one foot in front of the other. Oh, I'm the unit, baby. I was the one that did it. I did it all. Ha ha ha. I can hit a dime through an end of a tube. Motherfucker. Time to get on a roll again.
alien world? It's bright. In fact, it's so bright, it blinds you even looking at it from this distance. It's the Eater of the Universe! Say hello to my little friend, Dirtbag. When I killed you, I thought of my son of a bitch father. I can never stand that damn fucking Fu Manchu either. And that's why Droid drives me to kill you for starting this blood death match with me.
And our first contestant for our bonus deathmatch, the super heroic death dealing warriors of Pleiades, the quick space Marine Corps mightiest field operation unit known as Ranger. Nothing stops these Pleiadian death machines. Bang, bang, bangity boom, bang, bang, kabooms, give me some more quake shrooms. Ranger is fully packed with a state of the art alien arsenal and secret extraordinary powers and abilities. Some leading to the amalgam of the Doom Marine. Omnipotency, omnipotency, give me more omnipotency. I'm super bad. Though Ranger lacks instant or granted superficialities, he still can copy most of the Doom Marine because he is the other Doom Marine. Wait a minute, sorta like. Ranger is like a Doom Marine in disguise. Could you be a backup of some deranged thief stole Doom on you, huh? Anyways, now since we have the Ranger explaining in quite details, on to our next contestant. And from the UNSC, the most bullshit job space bugs in the nearest atmosphere. Notice I said the nearest. Is the iron-nerved, down-to-earth, military tough chauvinist of Halo, Avery Johnson. Pride, glory, honor, action, you name it. This guy is made of top-class non-silly putty. Jarhead bad boy steel. With an instinct to kill and the training of a hypnotized madman, Avery Johnson is worth it all. An expendable unit willing to die for any cause. Even if it involved taking out a mugger. Well, it's a cause. Well, now with Sergeant Major Avery Johnson explained, let's get on to a Strogos deathmatch.
Johnson, we believe these people are actually very sentient beings.
Oh, Johnson, who is it even at the operational level of science? I can barely experience the very edge of the great, voidly cucumber of space and time. I am super extraordinary and sentient. Omnipotent! Oh, the artifacts holds a little secret, Papa Doc Johnson.
I can operate at light speed. The fuck you talking about, maggot? I can operate at light speed! You trying to quick crack my ass up, boy?
Oh, it will, Johnson.
Real drop dead blokes, Johnson. Then what the fuck is all this beeswax then?
Ha 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 ha
can operate at! Light speed.